now we're going to analyze the string.
And the first step for quality control would be?
Well, this tensile string machine. And this test is made every day for each string that comes from our factory.
OK, and this machine, it applies tension to the
right.
to breakage, correct?
Correct.
And you can test all kinds of string?
Yes. We can do this test with all kinds of strings.
So monofilament, multifilament?
Yes.
The same.
So now it starts.
So we just had a set of NRG squared 17 gauge on the machine, and we stretched it until it broke. Can you explain, Frederick, what this tells us about the properties of the string?
Yes. This test can show us if the quality of the string is okay or not. And so we have to measure the force that we need to break the string. So if the value of the force is under 70 for this string, so we have a problem with our machine. If the value is above 70, everything is okay. So we do this test every morning on each string of the factory.
Okay, and that tells you if there's a problem with one of the machines, that string isn't being wrapped right or something like that. Okay, great. Let's have a look at the next, some of the other testing you do. Frederick, what does this machine measure?
This machine measures all the playability properties of the string. That's what we call our dynamic test.
Okay, you want to take us through the process?
Yes. So firstly, you have to put a weight of 20 kilos here in order to put like 20 kilos of tension on your strings. That's it. So the tension is not exactly 20. It's always a little bit lower than 20. So you have something like 19.5, 19.3.
So now we have the string. Now you're locking the tension in, correct? So the string is held
yes.
at that tension?
So now I can put this up. And now with this hammer, I'm going to hit the string. And the shock here is very aggressive for the string.
Okay.
Here we have a laser light that measure the movement of the hammer.
Okay.
So if your string is very dynamic, the hammer will come back very quickly from here. But if you have a very lazy string like polyester monofilament, the hammer will take more time to come back.
So the more powerful the string, the more the hammer will rebound.
That's correct.
Okay.
I can do it another time. We also measure the tension on the string. And we can see which strings holds better the tension between multifilaments, monofilaments, or different multifilaments, different monofilaments. And we can also measure the overtension. That's what we call comfort.
Frederick, we just had a look at the machine in action, but the information is captured here on the computer screen. Can you explain to us the data that's presented?
Yes, of course. So there are three very important values for us on this graph. The first important value is the value here which represents the tension loss of the string. You have also the value here of the tension. If you make the difference between this highest value and this lowest value, you have the overtension. That's what we call comfort. And the last value, very important, is the value of the area here between the two inside the graph, and this represents the power of your string. The thinner the area is, the more powerful your string is.
There's one final step in the lab where you test durability, correct?
Correct. Yes.
And can you explain what happens here? Like, this is a special racket. It's not actually a racket head, but it resembles one.
So it's yes, in fact, it's a frame made in with metal, and that allows us to make tests with no variations between the rackets. You know, rackets is made with carbon, and carbon has a life duration, and this is why we use metal, because metal doesn't move in the time.
Can you explain to us how this machine works, what it's going to do to the string?
Okay, sure. So this machine has a hammer that hit the frame of from one side to the other side. And that makes the main moving from up and down, up and down. And that makes frictions. This is we can count the number of hits that we need to break the string, and this is that gives us a first idea of the durability of the string.
Okay, so that's how they measure the durability in the lab. Let's head out to the tennis courts right now, and we'll see Patrice Kushner. They call him the human machine because he is a tennis player, but when he hits the ball, he's very much like a machine. He hits it at extreme spin, the same every time, and so it's a human measuring durability, much like the machines here in the lab.